It's a huge trend these days of taking animated classic films and making live-action versions of them. So today, we want to empower machine learning to help us generate what live-action versions of animated classic films would look like.
It's just a matter of time until AI reboots all of our favorite movies. All right.
What's a character Let's we see. Can make live-action?
We can take Tom Hanks and make Woody from Toy Story look like Tom Hanks.
Yeah. We got Tom Hanks. Now we have an image of Woody, a character he plays in Toy Story. Let's make a real man.
Woo! Toy Story!
Hey there! Andy! You got a friend in me!
Have you guys ever heard of RunwayML? It's this program that is free to download, and it is basically a way for anybody to experiment and create with machine learning. Nico has been messing around with it a lot, like for months in the studio, and all of us have kind of just picked it up and just been messing around with it, and it yields some super hilarious results.
So this is really cool. Here's how the process works. Basically, we take an input image of a face.
I feel like we should do Buzz Lightyear.
Buzz Lightyear. All right, let's parse that face. Basically, this is gonna use AI to look at a person's face and basically split it up into different parts. It's the skin, the nose, the eyes, eyebrows, hair, neck, and give us a basic image that shows us all the different components of a face.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, it's a little jacked up.
You can't salvage anything from that.
We have to do this manually, boys.
Oh, man. If your segmentation comes out kind of janky like this, you can actually just take the same color and drawn by hand so that the AI will recognize that now as skin.
It's identified all the parts of the face, and now what we're gonna do is take those parts of the face and give it a style image. I think Tim Allen's getting the boot. Tim Allen's cool, but I think we need an it guy.
Terry Crews. He could be a great Buzz Lightyear.
Here's another face that we want you to reference and rebuild this face in the style of the first face.
Sam's rendering with the cloud, so it allows you to use cloud processing for these actions.
It's computing everything on their GPU servers. Their private machine learning
their
cloud.
Private Nimbus.
Their little Nimbus on a leash. And that's what RunwayML really is that it's basically just this huge repository of machine learning
algorithms?
Networks? Algorithms? Networks? GANs?
GANs?
Generative adversarial networks?
Buzz Lightyear. Terry Crews. Give us our boy.
Let's go.
Oh! Oh!
Ah! Oh! No, dude.
That's pretty jacked up.
What
looking.
Did it do?
I mean,
it just looks like a scared, horrified thumb. What other great animated movies deserve a reboot?
The Up Grandpa, as Clint Eastwood.
I think we should get a younger actor.
Dude, Mark Ruffalo.
Oh yeah, Mark.
Danny DeVito.
Oh yeah, it's Danny DeVito. Perfect. Oh, this is too good. Up, old man.
Okay.
All right.
Let's just go with it. Let's just go with it.
We got a face.
Okay.
We got Danny DeVito.
Come on. I mean,
that face could.
Oh, wow. Okay. That's not bad.
It looks like Stan Lee a little bit.
That one was tough. It didn't really give us a lot of information to work with. Let's take another character.
Ninja Turtle. Dude.
Wait, dude.
Yeah, dude.
No! Live action Ninja Turtles. Joe Rogan as a Ninja Turtle.
Joe Rogan as a Ninja Turtle! Will this even work? The proportions are all different from a human. I mean,
I think we can get this
bad.
To work.
The mouth is perfect. The nose is almost there. We just need to add the eyes and shape the face, and we're good. Teenage Mutant Ninja Rogans.
Oh!
Oh! Oh my God.
Thanos is technically an animated character. You think you'd make a better Thanos? Joe Rogan as Thanos.
It's entirely possible.
Wow.
He just looks like even meatier now. Who would play Elsa from Frozen? They're gonna reboot this live action totally. Tom Holland?
Definitely Tom Holland.
And I think you'd be really like...
Progressive.
It'd be honestly, very progressive to cast a young boy as a young woman.
Very brave.
Tom Holland as Elsa, be brave. Whoa.
That actually like produced something. It's got like all the shading underneath the neck.
Look
and
the neck.
That's
the neck's
actually
crazy.
Like, as far as like realistic faces that this thing has generated so far, this is the closest.
Yeah.
He I would think Logan probably Paul should do be Elsa.
Yes. You did VFX right. for him, right?
Okay. Photography is great.
Topography.
Ooh. Okay, so they're incredibly similar. It's basically using skin tone, hair color, those really basic features. What other great animated movies deserve a reboot?
Ice Age Baby!
Oh, yeah! Freaking Ice Age Baby, man!
Who would play the Ice Age Baby?
What about Adam Driver?
Oh, Adam Driver. That's actually not bad at all.
Yeah.
Dude, Ice Age Baby all grown up. Leave a comment if you agree that Adam Driver is Ice Age Baby grown up.
Whoa! All right, this is gonna be good.
It's got the mouth and nose well enough.
I'm pushing this one through, guys. Oh!
Oh, God!
It's actually pretty close, except for that giant, like, mutant-like
thing. What did you make, Sam? What's really cool is that, like, even though the AI isn't perfect, it knows how to combine the elements, at least in a way that kind of makes it look like they belong together. You can draw like just a skin circle, right? And it won't look like anything. But once you put the nose on there, the AI will actually know like, okay, like I'm gonna contour and kind of like emboss like the face to give you those proportions and like shadows.
That Ice Age baby is demented.
Well, the guys are out there messing with their AI face generation. I thought it would be fun to come back here and see if I could play around with a little AI myself. Now, courtesy of today's sponsor, Vessi Footwear, I actually have been messing around with an AI shoe generator. And, well, quite frankly, there's no way that this thing has the computing power to actually deliver this beautiful, magnificent shoe right here. You see, the thing that AI can't do is come up with a 100% waterproof, ready for any weather sneaker. Not only can you wear these in the mud, in the rain, in the snow, in the sleet, they're also made of a patented Dymatex material, meaning that they keep you cool in the summer and keep you warm in the winter. When was the last time you heard of AI doing that? I haven't. Another thing AI can't do is give you one of the most flexible sneakers on the market. I mean, these things are so stretchy and so comfortable, it feels like you're barely even wearing a shoe. You can wear this hiking, you can wear it on a date, you can wear it to the office, you can wear it on run. So if you guys are interested in getting $25 off your own pair of Vessies, head on over to vessifootwear.com/corridorcrew, and that's exactly what you'll get. $25 off vessifootwear.com/corridorcrew. I think I'm gonna go for a run.
So the face parser here, it's a little janky as you can see, but that's because the face parser is designed to take apart human faces, standard human faces. That's what it's trained for. So we're throwing these animated characters, these CG characters at it, and it's really challenging.
Sam, you're basically using this parser to automatically generate the face maps, but yeah. What I kind of want to do is, there's a different model that allows you to hand draw. What's cool about manually drawing it is you can get more detailed than this. I think if I just spend a little bit extra time really taking an artist's touch to these separations here. Yeah. There's some super funny results I think we could get from that.
And I want to try, so obviously this works best when it's going from a human face to a human face. Yeah. So I want to test a bunch of different configurations to see how these GANs deal with human faces. Okay, all right, so Nick and I are gonna work on these little experiments here, and once we're done, we're gonna show everyone what we've made. So yeah, stay tuned.
You know, if you want to see us do some other experiments with machine learning, we did a Tom Cruise deepfake and a Keanu Reeves deepfake, which are both machine learning based visual effects. And those videos are actually pretty cool, so go check them out if you haven't seen them before.
Wow, Sam's here.
Everybody's here. So we spent the last hour or so just like trying to whip together some cool things. So I was trying to explore like what it would look like if I converted myself to myself through this process.
This is, it parsed your face and then you gave it your own face as an input to reconstruct it.
Yeah.
Ellen DeGeneres, wow.
So then I tried combining Jenna. So my wife and I, if we were to have a kid, it's gonna look like this.
Oh, she's like beautiful.
Or this. So that's what our kids will look like, I guess.
Dude, these eyeballs, it's like you have some sick disease, like parasite living in your eyeball.
So then I decided to go through and convert everyone to everyone. I took 9 photos of various other people. I'm trying to get every possible permutation of all of our faces here. So 9 times 9, that's 81. I should end up with 81 different faces that are generated. This is Christian. I found Christian kind of interesting how he, just for whatever reason, looks like a Russian Eskimo. Because it's basically forming it off of that one initial parsed image. So this is Clint.
Wow. Dude, these are really pretty cool. Good.
That's like really old, leathery Clint.
Yeah. I'll take a Clint to Nico.
Yeah, so that this was interesting because he had those sunglasses on. This is Dean.
Wow.
This is actually surprisingly spot on.
Yeah, that's Dino.
Deanie Downey Jr.
Deanie Downey Jr.
Wait, this is just a boy band.
Okay, and this is Griffin. Seriously, I kept wondering why Griffin's face was so rounded, and it only just occurred to me, it's the beard. It's converting your beard into a face.
It's giving me lip gloss and all that.
Yeah. It's gotta be just going, looking at like the hairstyle.
Anytime there's hair that's that long, it's usually a woman's hair.
Good job, Griffin, for confusing the AI. So Matt on Matt.
Wow, look at me, I'm such a beautiful boy.
You look ill. It's like Brendan Fraser combined with
Jeremy Renner.
This one might be my favorite. Which celebrity does Nick look like?
George Clooney.
Oh,
dude, that's Steve Carell.
Steve Carell.
Oscar Isaac. That's where I went.
That one?
There, that's definitely Jeff Goldblum.
Jeffy? Yeah, I can see that.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised if there's elements of those actors literally being used for this picture because it's probably been trained on just as many pictures as they can get, and I'm sure a lot of it's just celebrity headshots.
That's a good point. Nico on Nico, for whatever reason, just looks like an old lady.
Princess Diana.
Crazy.
Computers suck at this.
Nick made some stuff. Whoa! What is this?
This is the first time I did a manual segmentation from a picture of me, and this is what I got the first time.
Weird.
However, I did a second time, and I went way more in detail with drawing myself. I really tried.
Oh, you drew.
It's really good, actually.
Mm.
Yeah.
If you blur your eyes and don't think about it.
It's really weird how it's like the hand-drawn like proportions,
yeah,
but shaded realistically.
Whoa, whoa.
So this is my face trained on an avatar picture. It's the same drawing, the same segmentation I drew. Wow. But I put an avatar that it's referencing instead of me.
That's creepy.
So this is, really tried to draw this one. Like, this is the one I took like 15 minutes really trying to draw.
And she looks like she's in pain.
Yeah.
She looks like she's suffering.
Well, the Navi are suffering.
We are suffering.
Smeagol!
Ooh, he's got the weird like eye condition.
Beautiful. This is the best one.
I love that one. I really like that one. It's that weird like fleshy like, oh gosh. Yeah. This is creepy when it's real.
That was awesome, guys. Those are some great pictures.
I hope. And this is with like an hour's worth of work. Imagine if we actually put weeks into this. What could we create then?
Honestly, my takeaway from this is that AI and machine learning is accessible to everyone now, and it's super fun to mess around with.
It's just super early days, so it's like this stuff is just constantly getting better and better.
So we want to do a lot more of this like machine learning exploration stuff.
And there are so many more little programs to use within RunwayML. Yeah. We haven't even scratched the surface of what's available. If you've checked it out, find your favorite one and let us know, and maybe we'll take a look at that one.
Ren reads every comment.
Every single one, especially the videos that have 8,000 comments.
So there's actually another video coming out soon that we've been working on for a while. A certain guy, my name is Snoop Dogg, he approached us because he had a deepfake project he wanted us to work on, and we did it for his upcoming music video. The video will drop when the music video drops. It should be sometime in the next week or two. We're not entirely sure. So if you subscribe to the channel, you'll be the first one to see it. Let's just say it involves a certain someone who's not with us anymore coming back.
Also, subscribe to see more of this thing.
What the hell is that?
Hey, next time.